أشهد أن محمد رسول الله.
Welcome to Islam in America. Today our topic is going to be maintaining an Islamic family in challenging times. Our guest today is Imam Muhammad Sayyid Adly, who is the Imam of Masjid Muslimin in Columbia, South Carolina. He's been with us before, and we're happy always to have him again. Thank you, and welcome again, Sheikh Muhammad Adly.
Thank you. Glad to be here. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة كل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين.
For our audience, yes, who doesn't know the Arabic
language, maybe
know some and not others,
yes,
would you share an explanation for what you just recited?
We recited Khutbat al-Hajah, which is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam usually start with his speech with. What it says, the meaning is, all praise is due to Almighty Allah. We thank Him, we praise Him, we seek His help, His guidance, and His forgiveness. We believe in Him and we trust Him. We seek refuge in Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship other than Allah Rabbil Alameen, and I testify that Muhammad is His messenger and the seal of all the prophets. All you believe, fear Allah as He's supposed to be feared. Fear Allah and don't die unless you are in a state of Al-Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cause us to die on Al-Islam. Ameen.
Ameen. Thank you so much. Some of us may have understood it, others not, but now I think all have a clear understanding of what you were saying. Now, if we can think about challenges that are facing us in the society today or in our lives today that is creating a challenge for us in maintaining our Islamic families. So maybe we could talk about some of those issues and then try and come up with some solutions or touch base or touch on the hand of some of those solutions to the problems, and then what Allah has said and what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said.
Indeed, it is a serious challenge, and believe it or not, this challenge is facing everybody regardless wherever they live. But we need to go back and listen a little bit and think about the production, because if you have any kind of a defect in anything, you understand, the defect is in the manufacturing itself. So we have, you understand, that machineries and engineering and plants and things like this, which produce cars, aeroplane, start from even safety pen and pencil until the hugest things that you use in your life. What is the family? What the challenge that facing the family? So we need to go and talk about the family itself.
Yeah.
So, and if you can produce a good family, that this halfway, you understand, to meet the challenge. But what is the family? Family start with what? What is the seed for a family? Is a husband and a wife. So now we want to see to go back more and start to think about how we can improve the production of the family. Because you don't get a child, understand, out of the air, out of the, yeah, okay?
No.
There is, so the production here that comes as a result of the marriage, because we Muslims,
exactly,
we don't have any other relation other than Islam, you understand, to be producing children.
Right.
So if you did not have the proper brick in the building,
mm-hmm,
now this is the collapse of the house, sooner or later, okay?
Right.
So basically we need to start to think from the moment even approaching marriage itself.
Yeah.
Because if you don't have the proper husband, which sooner or later is going to be, you understand, the father.
Mm, right.
And the father is the leader for the child.
Yeah.
And same thing, if you could not have the proper wife, mm-hmm, which is going to be sooner or later going to be the mother,
right,
you see?
Mm-hmm.
So we need to focus on this. And as a result of this, even he found that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying that tunkah al-mar'a li-arba, a man seeks marriage out of woman due to four things. Okay, what it cause a person want to marry such a woman? He may marry her because her beauty, because her wealth, or because her lineage, her family, famous big family, or because her religion, her belief.
Mm-hmm.
So there is no other reason, you see. There is no other reason, and even we can see the wisdom of what the Prophet is saying. Why a man going to marry a woman, such a woman? We could not find any other one unless it goes under this four.
No.
But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying,
what if it's the cousin?
Excuse me?
What if it's the cousin of the lady across the street that's cute?
The cousin?
Of the lady across the street who is cute.
Okay, could you is this what we say, her beauty?
It doesn't fit.
No, it is. It is, you understand, because we said beauty,
uh-huh,
wealth,
yes,
lineage,
yes,
or religion.
No.
This lady across the street, it has to be under one of these four.
Well, she's cute. She's pretty.
This what? Okay.
So you can marry her for her beauty, but what about her head? What's in her head?
That's what I'm saying. So the hadith is coming to say what? فَظْفَرْ بِذَاتِ الدِّينِ تَرِبَتْ يَدَكْ. So, yes, because she's cute, because she's rich, or because, but the Prophet say, yes, this is what it, in general people go for marriage for. But the Prophet given us the advice.
Yeah.
He said, فَظْفَرْ بِذَاتِ الدِّينِ تَرِبَتْ يَدَكْ. Marry a woman because her religion.
Yeah.
Otherwise you'll be loser, you see.
Yeah.
Beauty doesn't stay forever.
No.
Wealth comes and goes, okay? Family lineage is not going to do too much to you, understand? People everywhere, revolution, and who's king today can be in the prison tomorrow, or who's the princess or queen, it can be tomorrow something else.
Right.
But the things that stay with the person always, you understand,
right,
is the religion, is the belief, is the behavior, is the discipline.
Right.
Okay, so why? Why is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam want us to marry a woman who has this main quality? Because this woman going to be the teacher and the life example for the child from day one. Okay? So if you are not choosing the proper person to be the future leader of your son or your daughter, you already that challenge, you fail that challenge from day one. Therefore, it is very, very important that before we talk about family, we talk about husband, talk about wife, talk about the first choice when you want to go to get married. Do not jump in marriage because any other reason than to be a person who going to be helping you, assisting you to mold the future, to shape the future of your future generation. This is something very important.
No, so then it would be a viable thing for, not on a private basis, but in a collective environment, for this future husband and this future wife to, in the presence of others, some others, to communicate what are their expectations of their life.
Of course, we don't believe, you understand, in somebody going to marry a woman, you understand, because his mother like her, or because his father, or arranged marriage.
Yeah.
In Islam, it is. Yeah. It is the right of the husband, as well as the wife, to know who's their future partner.
Right.
You could not get to understand two people and put them together because the culture, or because the mother like her. What about the son? Does the son going to live with her, not the mother?
Right.
You understand? So it is very important that these people, of course, there is a prerequisite of Islam, but how they're going to sit, how they're going to talk, it's no privacy, all these things.
Right.
But they have this right to get to see each other,
right,
and to value each other,
right,
and to see if this is the right partner or not.
Right.
It's very important.
Yeah.
Yes.
Because I'm thinking about when we start to talk about the challenges that are facing us today, if there is not some kind of cohesiveness between the husband and the wife,
matching,
how are you able to stick together?
To communicate and to match, to understand. Yes, it
how
is.
How are you going to handle these challenging times?
Exactly.
That
yes.
is before us.
Yes, we have to know that we have the same intention, that we have the same goals, that we thinking does not have to be exactly the same, but that we close in thinking, that we have the same goals, that we desire and understand the same thing.
Exactly.
Somebody is thinking about, I want to build a factory, build a house, I want to have a big mansion with a swimming pool. It's fine, but what else after this, you understand? And the other person, no, I like speeding car and fancy car. So it's two different things. Somebody wants to understand the child to have a child and memorize Quran. The other person wants to be a football player.
No. So in other words, you need to be on the same page.
We need to put everything in the table and discuss
right.
it.
Right, and you need to be
exactly.
on the same page.
Exactly.
Because if one is wanting one thing, the other
yes.
one is wanting the other,
exactly.
it's automatically in the household it's
yes.
going to be pulling apart.
Exactly, exactly.
Not to mention mm-hmm. the impact of
the society and the outside
from,
of the house, all these things.
Exactly.
And by the way, also, because now we say this is like a step number one.
Mm-hmm.
But after this, you see that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that every child is born in the upright nature.
Mm-hmm.
But his parents, كُلُّ مَوْلِدٌ يُولَدُ عَلَى الْفِطْرَةِ. Every child is born in the upright nature.
Right.
Now the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying about the environment and the challenge that we will try on the, but he say his parents are the ones that caused him to be a Jew or a Christian or a Megan. He did not say or make him Muslim, because in actuality the child when he born on the proper nature, on Tawheed. If he living alone without any disturbance from the outside, he will get to know who is Allah, that Allah is one, that he's not three. But the effect and the impact of the father and the mother, this was going to make the corruption. And this is the first challenge,
mm-hmm.
that meeting our children, that you have a father that Muslim by name, or a mother Muslim by name, or both of them are Muslims by name and culture. When Ramadan comes, a Ramadan Muslim, so a seasoned Muslim.
No.
Okay, this will be this is the problem now. So you did not have the proper environment from the beginning. So you could not sit and say, we need to see how we're going to deal with the challenge at meeting our children. We already been a challenge from day one, you understand, before we did not prepare, you understand, the ground for this.
And, yes. Right. And it's really, if you think about it, you know, we plan for this and that and all of these things,
everything,
but
now
we haven't planned how to live our lives
because
together,
the way that our society affecting us, that everybody, you understand, the media, the neighbors, everybody's talking about this temporary life. But we, the Muslim, because we are not also, this is a challenge, one of the challenges, we are not surrounding ourselves with the proper environment.
Exactly.
So when you sit with people who always talking about games, or people who are always talking about the swimming pool and the fancy house, you're going to start to talk the same thing. The children going to be talking the same thing. There is a difference between taking a child and grow among the environment in a forest and see monkeys and things like this jumping in trees. He's going to start doing the same thing. And you're taking a child and get him in raise him in among the human being in a proper discipline and a proper talking, no cursing, no all these things. He's going to grow in the same, doing the same thing. So we need the parent, the husband and wife, we need the parents, we need the school, okay? We need the society, you need the neighbors. There is a lot of challenges, okay? So, but we give example, you understand, like, two partners getting together.
Yeah.
We talk about the father and mother, you understand?
Mm-hmm.
The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave a good example about the environment or the impact.
Mm-hmm.
Although it's a longer hadith, but I try to make it short about الرجل الذي قتل 99 نفسه, a man who killed 99 people.
Mm-hmm.
And finally he decided he wants to repent, to be a good Muslim.
Yeah.
So he asked how I can. So they advised him to go to see a scholar to give him a fatwa or an answer.
Mm-hmm.
But they directed him to a worshiper.
Mm-hmm.
That I mean a person who making a prayer, but he doesn't know. He has no knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
The information, the proper information, he doesn't have. He has a good heart. So when he came, he told him, I killed 99 people. Can I repent? So, no way. You fill the earth with blood, you are this and that, you could know, no way you can. So he took him and he killed him. So now became 100 instead of 99.
Mm-hmm.
Later on, he felt sorry again and I want to repent, I want to be a good. So he searched for a scholar and this time he been led to a scholar.
Yeah.
The scholar told him, yes, Almighty God, Allah will accept, welcome you back.
Mm.
But, listen to this, he told them you need to depart from this area that you're living in. Because, فَإِنَّهَا أَرْضُ سُوءٍ وَأَذْهَبَ إِلَى أَرْضِ كَذَا وَكَذَا فَإِنَّ بِهَا أُنَاسٌ صَالِحُونَ يَعْبُدُونَ اللَّهِ فَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ مَعَهُمْ وَلَا تَعُدْ إِلَى أَرْضِكَ فَإِنَّهَا أَرْضُ سُوءٍ. He said, you need to migrate. What is the migration for? Because the other side is green? Because what is there? He said, where you are, your environment is surrounded with the evil people doing the same thing like you, okay? Lesser degree or more degree. But go to so and so place because there is a Muslim community, there is a good Islamic environment, and they worshiping God. Be with them, don't come back here.
Yeah.
And the man actually took the advice and he start his journey right away.
Mm-hmm.
So this tells us the environment is very important for our children.
Yeah.
Now, the challenge meet our children with the schools, public schools, okay? And if it's not the teachers corrupted, some of the children are so corrupted.
Yeah.
Some of these kids, they have a TV, some of them, they have cables, some of them, they don't have parents' control or advice, because they leave it, okay? The father go outside, you understand, because they don't have so-called moral
values
and discipline in the house. So The father want to go, the mother want to go, and the child have nothing to do. He have 2 months, he understand, out of the school. He can be looking to any channel in the TV. So now the children, they talk to each other. So you can have a corrupted students, mm-hmm. or you can have a corrupted teachers. Mm-hmm. So the environment for our children is danger. Mm-hmm. And it can mislead them. Now you hear about so-called sex education in schools nowadays, okay? And basically what this teaches them, the opposite of what Islam teaches them. Mm-hmm. Because here Allah say, وَلَا تَقْرَبُ الزِّنَا. Don't come near adultery. Don't come anything that it may make you eventually fall in adultery. But the schools, it teaches them, yes, you can do it, but somebody who has the same age like you. But you have to have some kind of protective measurements. And so basically what God is teaching and what the school is, it's totally...
It's two different things. Right.
So it's not only the children going to teach other different things, but the mixing itself, the physical education itself, yeah. girls with shorts and boys, you understand, standing... swimming classes, mix... Okay. And after this, they come with so-called sex education, teaching the kids about how to indulge in things like this. So, how are you going to meet this challenge?
Well, I think that these are some of the challenges. And what I think we as Muslims have
exactly.
to do is wake up and smell the coffee. And realize that
the coffee is already in our...
Well, we reach out. Wake up and come into reality.
Yes.
Because the challenges exist. And maybe some of us are not able to move away from the challenges.
Exactly.
So what we need to do is pick our friends.
Okay.
So that we can make our own community among our friends.
Let's talk about our friends. This
right,
is very good.
Because if our friends are not of the same mindset we are, and their children are not going to be...
One rotten apple in the box.
In the back. So your children are playing with these people, children who are not on the same page with you.
Mm-hmm.
It contaminates
true.
What you are trying to do in your home.
So
to maintain
here the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, "Mathalul jalis al-salih wa jalis al-su, kaba'i al-misk wa nafkh al-kir." The company, the good company, and the bad company. Is like a person who's selling perfume mm-hmm. or a person who blow in the furnace.
No.
So who you going to sit with? And there is a statement say, As-sahib, sahib. Yeah, that means your companion mm-hmm. is the one who lead you. He will lead you, okay? Mm-hmm. Does not mean if I don't smoke, and you smoke, or you don't smoke and I'm smoking, and you be... Spending time with me, going with me places, sooner or later you're going to be doing the same thing. You understand?
Right, right.
Even if you don't want to do it. The bad influence of... Come on, man. You love me. Okay, you're careful. Come on. One time. At least... This is the way. Yeah. They be joking, playing on the start. Everything start like this. So the Prophet ﷺ said, bad company and good company. Good company like a person who sells perfume.
Yeah.
If I'm selling perfume, so I'm carrying a good fragrance.
Mm-hmm.
So even you sit here, you still smell it.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because this is the impact of being carrying perfume.
Yeah.
Okay.
Something
so
good.
The same thing, your company is going to have some impact in you. But if your companion or your friend or whosoever that you go camping with, homework with, or whatever that reason that you, okay, is going to be like a person who blow in the furnace. When you go to the blacksmith, he sits in the shop, waiting for him to finish molding, you understand, and shaping this fence that you're going to put it in your window or whatever it is for protection, making the gate for you. He's blown in the furnace and all the sparkles coming out. It comes in your... It can burn it. You see?
And this whole idea of this happening still falls back on this whole thing that you spoke about in the beginning of planning.
Yes.
When you get ready, you pick your wife or you pick your husband, who you're on the same page.
Exactly.
But then you have to also, not by random not randomly plan your live your life in your household. No, but you actually have to plan it.
Every day.
You have to plan every day.
What is going to be my neighbor? What is my school going to be for my children? What is everything? This is true.
What is going to happen in your household? Mm-hmm. When the husband go out to make this
out of town or whatever.
Out of town.
Yes.
What is the wife supposed to do?
Absolutely.
But they have to sit and talk about this.
They need to educate themselves.
Right.
They need to go for classes, workshops. They need to read things. I understand because we are the soldiers.
No.
This is our small community.
No.
My son and my daughter, this is our community,
no.
Okay? That we're going to be questioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of judgment about it.
No.
And we don't know how you understand to guard whenever they play this role. So we need to ask those who know. As Allah says, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Ask those who know if you don't know. So there is a lot of people that spend a lot of time talking about education, about training, about workshops, about raising children, about nourishment, fostering kids, all the things. And we're going to need this, but we don't want only to take it as a knowledge. We need to take it and start to act on it. Because if you're moving from Houston, Texas, coming all the way to Raleigh, why is Raleigh? Okay, because you understand they open a new factory there, I will get more money, more raise. But what about the children?
Mm.
Is there an Islamic school there?
Mm.
Is there, do you know, any Muslim family there you're going to be? So we plan for this life, but these things weekend Islamic school. Weekend. How you weekend going to do for your child? You understand, like, exactly somebody drowning in the ocean and somebody who just getting trained to swim, to go to save a life of somebody drowning. It doesn't work like this.
Mm.
So what we're doing, we're moving from place to place with no planning for our children, and now we're assuming weekend Islamic school going to change our children.
Right, and we also think that somebody else is supposed
exactly.
to do it.
Yeah, drop the child there, as they say.
Right.
It's a must.
It's not any responsibility of mine to improve the community. No, it's the responsibility of all of us to upgrade, elevate the community.
This is true.
I was talking to a sister the other night, and we started to talk about Islam in America, Islam in the United States. And we were saying, the course of our conversation led to if we are not planning in our everyday life to have the facilities, to have the kinds of things in our community that Muslims need for their life, then, you know, we're dependent on some other
institution or somebody else to do it for us. They are not going to do it for us.
Oh, no, they have them, and you're welcome to come there to them,
yeah,
except that you've got to submit to
them. You have to match with everything.
You have to submit to their way of life as opposed to your way of life.
Yes.
So then it behooves you to plant your own environment the way you want it.
Exactly.
We have, alhamdulillah, we have masjids.
Mm.
We have schools.
Yes.
But burial grounds. So we have to have all of these things. But we cannot wait for so-and-so to do it.
No. We have to create ours because ours is different from theirs.
But we also have to realize that it's the responsibility of everyone. Not the big eyes or the little eyes. It's the yous and the us. It's really about
us. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in Quran. وَتَعَوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى. Help one another. And this is a serious problem, especially with adults. Everybody focusing about himself or his house. We are not having even the time to spend together to create alternative and facilities for our children.
Yeah.
And there is things which, a gym as example. I could not as one family build a gym. But when we get together, we can have a gym. If we want to understand to make a mosque, recreation areas, whatever it is, Islamic school. This, like I say, one hand doesn't clap.
Yeah.
You have to have both of them. So if the community, the Muslim community, don't come together really sincere and seriously they want to do change for the future of our children, we are losing if we are not already lost. There is a great number of children in teenagers, boys and girls, they are behind bars. Yeah. Or they've been already drowned in whatever going in the dunya. They yeah. are in the dunya.
But the that's one of the aspects that we have to come to grips with and face. We also have to come to grips with the seniors. You know, now the workforce is thinking in terms of not retirement at 60, 62, or 65. They're talking in 70
going up.
And going up.
Yes.
So now, the senior citizens, what preparations have we made for them? Mm. There are those who think that, oh, I'm going to take care of my parents at home. You don't know that that's possible because you don't know what your parents are going to need when they get to be seniors.
Yes.
So what environment do we have for them? There's a nursing home down the street, but they're serving ham and bacon and, you know, and all of the kinds of things that we don't eat. Or their scenario is quite different from ours. And I'm thinking now for myself.
Yeah.
I'm thinking, well, when I get to be, this is the joke part, when I get to be a senior citizen,
like me,
I want, what is available for me? If I become disabled or something, I have to go to somebody else's environment. Mm-hmm. Where is the environment where I can hear the Quran playing? Mm-hmm. Where is the environment where I can go in the back and plant my little garden? Or where is the environment where I can go and...
Or see another Muslim sisters
that you can talk with. That are on exactly. my chronological mm-hmm. age group mm-hmm. that I can sit and hold a conversation with. Mm-hmm. Because the bottom line is the children are going to be working until they're 70.
Mm-hmm.
So then you are going to be home alone. Or you're going to have somebody brought into the house that you got to watch 24/7 what's happening.
Yeah.
You know, so... We have to wake up and smell the coffee and take some responsibility
yes.
for establishing communities
yes. Yes.
that offer
that can work together
to bring about the kinds of things that is necessary for our lifestyle, for our life.
This, exactly. This you know, is what I'm saying, yes, that Allah said, help one another. Because there is a lot of things that you could not do it as an individual.
You can't do it
neither as a family. You need to... The Muslim Ummah, you understand, all these people that in one city to get together, or at least in one locality, try to create these things.
Create these
money
things.
Or time, and it have to be helping one another. But you found in most cases that people are divided, are separated, are distant from each other, and most of them, you understand, selfish, thinking about themselves, and they say, this is not going to bring about a better future for the Muslims in America or wherever they are.
No. So what can we do now about this? Because the bottom line is, when I say that we need to be establishing communities, that if you look at it, we can look, you know, we don't have to reinvent the wheel. We can look at our neighbors. We can look at the Christians and see how they've managed to, they have their, quote, nursing homes. And I hear a lot of Muslims say, oh, I'm not going to put my mother in a nursing home. I'm not going to have my father put in a nursing home. Trust me, they're there already. But the other thing is, where are you going to put them then? Because you're going to be working until you're 70 years old.
Mm-hmm.
What is your 90-year-old parent going to be doing home alone? Or you're going to have somebody come in that's working 9 to 5 or 7 to... You see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
What do...
It's a lot. It's a lot. You're talking about nursing home. You're talking about Islamic schools. You're talking about... There many, many alternatives need to be built by the Muslims. So the Muslim, if they are not going to acknowledge the seriousness of the time and the surrounding, and they are not going to create alternative and other
daycare centers,
It's a lot. Basically, everything that we need. But it has to start with the awareness. The people have to know there is a challenge facing them and facing their children and facing our future and facing Islam itself, okay? If you go to any mosque, okay, look, where is the youth? Do you see any youth there? Can they come to Jum'ah, as example? A child 20 years old and he did not attend Jum'ah for the last 5-10 years because they have a schools, okay? Is actually the people have to come to realize that we are been facing with a lot of challenge, okay? Even in the media itself, there's a challenge, okay?
No.
We have the TV, we have the cable, we have all the things. What we can watch?
Well,
what our children going to watch?
No, they're watching plenty. What we need to do is how are we going to control that watching? But the other thing is how are we going to also establish in the community.
Your media and your own shows and your program, okay?
Exactly.
Because we are not only to create for ourselves. What about we're supposed to be giving da'wah to others?
Vice chairman.
Where is the cables or the TV or the channels that a whole United States, if you looked at how many TV Christian channels only for preaching, hundreds.
Right.
But tell me about one, you understand that? A full time, as example, okay?
So what are we going to have to do? Because we need steps.
We have a big job.
We have a big job,
yes.
Without a question, without a doubt. But what are we going to do? That's the reality. What steps can we take? So it has to start from the top down. It has to start from the shura and the imams getting together, identifying the problems in the community and addressing them, setting up committees. And trust me, brother, Ya Allah, Imam Muhammad, in our community of Muslims here in the United States, we are probably the most highly educated people in America.
Mm.
And this is a fact. And you will find in these places with technology, you'll find it full of Muslims. And in medicine, you'll find it
exactly.
Full of Muslims. So in social issues, full of Muslims. But these people are not coming into the community and establishing leadership and training and feeding to our children. So what we going to have to start to do?
When you go to the hospital, how many doctors see them, you understand, Muhammad and Abdul and all these things? Go to any, in a higher position, you know, found these Muslims everywhere. But what is their contribution to the, I bought $10 in the charity box. We don't keep your $10 for you. We need something else.
We need you.
Exactly.
You know, like Uncle Sam used to say,
need your time. We need your input. You need your advice. You understand? Because me, I can teach you the religion. But you understand, everything you need to do, it have to build, you understand, have to be in the frame of religion. But we need your ideas. We need all your invention.
Yeah,
we need all these things. We need it here so we can put our hands together and do something.
No.
This is a problem.
We have the importance of the of education and being knowledgeable in the revealed knowledge, but we also need knowledge and education in the secular area so that we can Islamatize it to fit our needs in our communities. So we've got to get some of these people, we've got to develop a database that can pull in the people. We, in our community, trust me, we have scholars in every area.
This is true.
We have nurses, we have doctors, we have lawyers, we have engineers, we've got it all. But we're not utilizing it in our communities.
See,
and this is one of the challenges that's holding us back.
Life, especially in America, is very fast and doesn't allow the people, you understand. You're talking about somebody who wake up like 5:30 in the morning, get ready to leave, and after this they come about 9 o'clock at night, Okay, so barely is he waiting for the weekend to rest or to take it easy or to see the family. So they do not even have time for themselves because the dollar became the main thing in their life. We have fast life in America, okay? We don't have the, we have the challenge.
But they make it to the game.
Exactly, you're absolutely right.
They make it to the game, they have time for that. So here again, the importance of setting up a schedule for your home in your environment.
Yes.
Because the basics of Islamic community really starts in the home.
We need to learn about sacrifice. This is what we need to learn. We need to go and study about the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even wanted him to sacrifice his own son.
No.
We see how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had left Mecca. He loved Mecca so much. So, because if sacrifice, this component of called sacrifice, if it's missing from the Islam, okay, you could not build anything. You are not going to do anything. So I think this is something need for to be revived, this teaching of sacrifice. And doing things for the pleasure of Allah, you have to sacrifice. It's going to have to be some kind of time sacrifice, money sacrifice, all these things for you to be able to build something or to correct and to face the challenge that, you see, the challenge became more every day, comes to be stronger every day.
Yeah.
As example, one thing that we know, that's very simple, that marijuana, as example, reefer, was illegally, okay?
Mm-hmm.
But now we notice that in different states, okay, now they legalize it, okay?
Yeah, yeah.
So that mean, how you going to, every day, what is prohibited, okay, by the law, they loosen it up, okay? And they try to find a means and ways now to make it okay for the people.
Mm-hmm.
So the challenge is facing our children and our community, and especially us as a Muslims, because we have a code of life that we have, a moral code especially, we have to live by it. We found that somebody else, you understand, given more, you understand?
Yeah. But the reality is, it all boils down to, it's on us. Because people around you can do anything or everything. We're not trying to follow them. We are supposed to be following the Quran.
It's true, but we, especially when talking about challenge for our children, they are weak, they are young, they are, you understand, seized. Don't forget the shaitan also there working in their mind, try to beautify the things for them.
But
so if, that there is a big challenge.
But if we are not, but if we haven't woke up and smell the coffee and have some plan to counteract this.
Believe me,
this is our responsibility.
I believe all that most of these people, they did not only smell the coffee, they drank the coffee and the coffee is already, but they already got used to. This is a serious problem.
Okay, but the Bible,
they got used to it.
Okay, they got used to it. That's the problem. This is everybody's problem. But what
we have to start to talk about it.
We got to come to grips.
Exactly.
We have to come to grips with the reality.
Yes.
And face that we need to get serious.
This, yeah, because we're going to be drowning sooner or later.
So it's the responsibility, not on one of us, but every one of us.
Yes.
You know, to step forward, come forward, and don't wait for somebody to ask you. Come and say, you know, I know so-and-so. I know how to do the technology on the telephone.
Mm-hmm.
I'm willing to teach anybody who need to know that. I know how to, I'm a social worker. I know how to deal with social issues. I'm a little bit contribution of everybody,
you're going to have something.
I'm a teacher. I can tutor some students once a week. There are so many things that we can do that can be done, but it means that we have to wake up and realize and come to grips with the fact that it's our responsibility. And we should not have to wait for somebody to organize it. We need to organize it. It's on you. You remember that thing that said there was a job that needed to be done.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody said that somebody would do it.
Uh-huh.
Somebody said that anybody could do it.
Yes.
And anybody said that somebody would do it.
Uh-huh.
When it was all done, said and done, nobody did.
Nobody did it.
And that's where we are.
Yes.
So we have to come to grips with it.
We could keep
talking about this and come up with many of the things that we need to be involved with in doing.
Yes.
So
we have to realize that the challenge is there, and it's getting more challenge every day. It's getting more stronger, and we have to fear for our children. And we have to be, you understand, as Allah said, "Qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nar." Save yourself and your children from hellfire.
Nah.
And we have to put our hands together.
But this is not only on us. The challenge is on everybody, on every community.
Yes,
other communities are coming to grips with it and working on it.
Mm-hmm.
We also have to come to grips and start to work on it.
Inshallah,
we will do that. Hopefully those of you who are watching will think about it seriously.
Mm-hmm.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that ayat again.
Inna Allah la yughayyiru ma biqawmin hatta yughayyiru ma bi anfusihim. Indeed, Allah never changes the condition of the people until they first change what is in their own self.
Thank you.
Alhamdulillah.
Sheikh Muhammad Adly.
Oh, don't tell me the time is over.
Please come back and be with us again.
Oh,
you see, we have to do this more often.
Sure, inshallah.
Okay. Well, assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you.